Hey, everybody. I wasn't going to do any kind of reading today. At least not yet. But I was about to take a nap because I'm tuckered the fuck out. Nine of Cups, lovers. And I just got a download. Spirit basically saying the twin flame is still in a state of devastation. They drew the Ten of Swords, the Three of Swords, and Justice. And I guess if there's anything I can do. Just because I want to go slow in any kind of starting of a relationship, and that doesn't matter whether it's this new guy, whether it's the old guy, whether it's any of the other potentials that we've talked about, even the twin flame, doesn't matter who it is, I want to take it slow, and I want to establish a solid relationship between us. Without intense romance or sex as a factor before I continue into something serious. I don't want to jump into anything serious because my name's Dylan. You know, in my last relationship, we started living together after 3 weeks. Was that intense? After 3 weeks, we were living together, and we were married after like 3 years. But I think DJ, that if I had really taken my time and analyzed the relationship and the red flags and how we were capable of changing or not changing, I might have made different choices back then. But I jumped in head first, based on my feelings. And I don't think I want to do that again. I want to be slower, more logical. And that includes platonic relationships. And, you know, competition and options. These masculines are still coming in pairs. Every single time. There's gotta be something. You know, and every single time I've come to the point where I'm like, okay, well, I have to decide if I want to focus on one or if I want to stay open to both or anything like that. I've done it all. I have removed all the masculines that I was interested from the table entirely without exploring anything. I have decided that I wanted to pursue one over the other, and that didn't work out either. I have decided to reject all new advances based on my loyalty to the Twin Flame. And that didn't work out either. And choosing myself didn't feel like any of those three options. So choosing nobody, choosing him, and choosing the new person, none of those three things led to me choosing myself. Me choosing myself was putting on my blinders and focusing on me. And that's what I'm doing now. I'm not worried about a relationship. I'm not worried about a man. I'm just focusing on what's making me happy and what's going to progress my life forward, my purpose. Seven of Wands and the Earth Angel. Standing my ground and walking in my purpose. But we keep on coming up with justice for this divine masculine. And for some reason, they keep on shoving it back in my face over and over and over again. Ever since the Twin Flame tree broke, I've been drawing the Twin Flame, the Three of Swords, over and over again. And the King of Wands, the Divine Masculine card, they're trying to tell me something about the amount of devastation that he's going through. Ace of Pentacles. In this new beginning, I'm getting the feeling that he didn't actually try and hold me back or send negative energy my way. It was more like, tell me, Spirit. The Empress and Temperance. Healing, rebirth. Balance. Coming into balance with each other. Divine justice, karmic retribution. I think he's paid the karma. Or not paid it. I think he's transmuted it. Because those are different, I think. Paying karma is just waiting for the meter to run through. Waiting for however it's going to land on you. Transmutation is different. It's running straight at your misdeeds and writing them and turning that energy into something positive, doing something good instead of paying for something bad. I think that there was a necessary ending, and it was bigger than an unplug and a replug. Strength. You know, I think we said it with the Four of Wands behind it. I think we said it back in the day. That I believed that in order for this to work, I would have to clear my karma, transmute it, start my new cycle after unplugging. He would have to clear his karma, get out of his cycles, and leave that cycle to enter a new one, and by exiting that figure eight of karma, that karmic relationship, with more than just an unplug and a replug, but a transmutation of energy, we would be able to come back together in a positive way. And again, that's not indicative of a relationship or platonic relationship, just that we would be able to come back together in whatever way. And the cards still say that's possible, probable, or even likely, because we know that he is part of our future. But we are at a crossroads here, and there is awakening and renewal before us. We have to be open to it and release the past.